In the stunning icy world of the Arctic, where towering icebergs keep watch and the cold air cuts through to the bone, there lives a creature that moves through the freezing waters with elegance and a touch of mystery. This creature is none other than the beluga whale. Belugas inhabit one of the most extreme environments on Earth, where the water temperatures can plunge well below freezing. Yet the beluga thrives, its stark white body camouflaged against the ice, and its social nature turning the silent, icy waters into an aquatic concert. So how do beluga whales thrive in some of the coldest waters on Earth? And why do they have a melon-shaped head? Welcome to the insane biology of the beluga whale. Beluga whales are known as the nomads of the sea. These remarkable creatures lead a nomadic lifestyle, constantly on the move in pursuit of food and suitable living conditions. Their journey takes them through some of the coldest waters on our planet, in the Arctic and subarctic regions. But beluga whales are not just casual visitors of these icy waters. They are full-fledged residents, spending their entire lives in the icy cold. Yet somehow, they've managed not to just survive, but to thrive in this freezing environment. They are able to do this through their incredible physical adaptations. One of the most significant adaptations of beluga whales is their thick layer of blubber. This isn't just any ordinary fat. It's a specialized tissue that functions as a remarkable insulator. This layer can be up to 5 inches thick and accounts for nearly 40% of the beluga's body mass. But their blubber isn't just for insulation. It also serves as an energy reserve during times when food is scarce. Beluga whales can go long periods without eating, relying on their fat reserves until they find a suitable food source. This adaptation is crucial for survival in the Arctic. The beluga's adaptations don't stop at insulation. You might have noticed that unlike other whale species, belugas lack a dorsal fin. This isn't due to any design flaw, but a clever adaptation to reduce heat loss. Since fins are thin and have a large surface area, they could potentially lose a lot of heat. By not having a dorsal fin, belugas minimize this heat loss, keeping their core temperature stable. Another fascinating adaptation is their skin color change. Beluga whales are born with dark gray or brown skin, a natural camouflage in the Arctic's murky waters. By adulthood, around 5 to 7 years, their skin turns white, allowing them to blend with the icy environment for enhanced survival. Their flexible neck, a characteristic that is not found in most other cetaceans. Unlike many marine mammals, belugas have unfused cervical vertebrae, giving them extraordinary range of motion. This flexibility allows them to turn their heads in all directions, making them exceptionally aware and interactive with their surroundings underwater. But what about their odd-shaped head? Beluga whales have a distinctive bulging forehead, also known as the melon. This physical trait might seem strange at first glance, but it's an essential adaptation that helps them survive in their environment. The melon acts as a lens, allowing beluga whales to use echolocation to navigate and communicate in their dark, icy environment. Echolocation works by emitting clicks through the forehead, which then bounce off objects in the water and return back to the whale's lower jaw. The beluga whale then interprets this information to locate food, avoid obstacles, and communicate with other whales, even in near total darkness, allowing them to thrive in the murky waters of the Arctic, where visibility is extremely limited. In the Arctic, food isn't always plentiful, but beluga whales make do with what's available. They're opportunistic feeders, consuming a wide range of prey, from fish and squid to crustaceans and other sea creatures. This flexible diet allows them to exploit a variety of food sources, ensuring their survival in a harsh environment. Belugas are known as social butterflies of the oceans. With their strong social bonds and tight-knit communities or pods that they form. These pods are typically composed of anywhere from 10 to several hundred individuals. And they're not just random gatherings either. Belugas are known to form complex social structures with relationships that can last a lifetime. They are also one of the most vocal marine mammals, nicknamed the Canaries of the Sea. They use a variety of clicks, whistles, and chirps to communicate with each other. Scientists believe that these vocalizations play a significant role in maintaining their social connections and strengthening their bonds. Known for their playful nature, beluga whales often engage in games, chase each other, or play with objects they find in the water. This playful behavior is not merely a source of amusement, but it also strengthens social bonds and teaches young whales important survival skills. The social structure of beluga whales is truly fascinating. Leadership within pods can be fluid between both males and females, often led by older, experienced whales, contributing to teaching the young essential survival skills, including hunting, communicating, and navigating through Arctic waters. Males leave their maternal pods when they reach maturity, and then form bachelor pods, which they will stay in until they are old enough to compete for mates. These whales also demonstrate a high level of cooperation within their pods. They work together to hunt, protect their young, and even help each other in times of distress. It's not uncommon to see one whale supporting a sick or injured pod member at the water's surface to help it breathe. Beluga whales undergo remarkable migrations that are crucial for their survival and reproduction. Each year, as the winter ice begins to melt, belugas move from the deep, dark waters of the Arctic to the shallow coastal regions. This annual migration allows them to take advantage of the seasonally abundant prey in these areas. What's truly fascinating is the precision of their migration patterns. Belugas have been observed returning to the same estuaries every year, a behavior that suggests a strong homing instinct. These estuaries provide not only rich hunting grounds, but also safer environments for the calves to be born and nurtured. However, these migrations are not without their challenges. Navigating through rapidly changing sea ice conditions demands exceptional adaptability and resilience. Additionally, the routes they travel are increasingly threatened by human activities, such as shipping and industrial development, increasing the risk of pollution and noise in beluga habitats. Noise pollution in particular interferes with beluga's ability to communicate and use echolocation. Another significant threat is climate change, exacerbating the challenges they already face in their Arctic habitat. The rapid warming of the Arctic is leading to decreased sea ice cover, altering marine ecosystems in ways that are not fully understood, but are clearly detrimental to beluga populations. Reduced ice cover affects the availability of prey for belugas, as the creatures they feed on also depend on ice-covered environments. Plus, warmer temperatures could lead to an increase in predatory species moving northward into beluga territories, introducing new competition and predation risks. Beluga whales are fascinating creatures that have uniquely adapted to thrive in their harsh Arctic environment. They embody the wonder and resilience of marine life in the Arctic. Their sophisticated social structures, intricate vocalizations, and remarkable migratory patterns underscore the complexity of their existence. As we continue to explore and study these magnificent creatures, let's be inspired to appreciate and protect the delicate balance of life in our oceans, ensuring a future where beluga whales and all marine life thrive for generations to come. Thank you for joining us on this journey into the insane biology of beluga whales. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button and give us a thumbs up. Until next time, keep exploring.